Hi, welcome to Lessons with John. Today we're going sailing. All right, this is Sailing. It's Rod Stewart recorded it. He did it in the key of B, which would be capo 4th fret if you want to do it in his key. I just left it, and I put it in the key of G. Like I said, capo 4th fret up here. You can do it like that, and that'll work out. I didn't base this on the song. He's got like a little intro thing and a guitar solo and all that stuff, but I just basically made it into a song you could play at church or a campfire type thing. It's like a gospel song. It's about losing, missing someone you've lost, that sort of thing. So you need a G chord, 6th string, 3rd fret, 5th string, 2nd fret. You could do the any G chord you want, 2nd string, 3rd fret, 1st string, 2nd, 3rd fret. Or you could just play the 1st string, 3rd fret. That G chord too. Any G chord will do. E minor is 5th string and 4th string 2nd fret. Everybody else is open. If you do it like that, you got to go to a C chord next. You could just pivot on your middle finger. So the C chord is the 5th string 3rd fret, 4th string 2nd fret, 2nd string 1st fret. You're going to need an A minor chord. So that's the 2nd string 1st fret, 4th string and 3rd string 2nd fret. Also going to need a D7, so that's the 3rd string 2nd fret, 1st string 2nd fret, 2nd string 1st fret. That's a D7 chord. Okay, so that's all the chords you need. So you got a G chord, and our strum, there's only two strums in this song. There's a long strum and a short strum. So the long one is down, 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 up, up, down, 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 up. Okay. C chord, back to G. I am A minor. Stormy water is E minor. To A minor near you. To B and a G to a D7. So that's our short strum. At the end, we have a G chord, and we're going to go down, 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 up. That's the first four moves of our long strum. And then we go to the D7, same thing, down, 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 up. So we do two short strums on those two chords, and then that leads us right back to the beginning of the song. And so pretty simple. Now, if D7 gives you trouble, which it almost did for me, it crept up on me, and because I wanted to play a D chord, because I saw the D, and I went to go play D, you actually can play a D chord. So if you're not familiar with D7, or you don't like it, or whatever, you could play a D chord there. It's perfectly fine. D7 just, it pulls you more into the key of G. It pulls you more towards a G chord. But D could be a substitute for it. It's a more vanilla type sound. But if you don't like the D7, you can substitute a D chord. Nobody's going to say anything. All right? So this is the song, Sailing, I've been sailing, da 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 dee. I've been sailing stormy water. Okay, so hopefully you know it. I always loved it. It's a great song. And I think you just play it this way, make it easy. C chord, back to G. I've been A minor. One more time. I'll play the D chord at the end this time so you can hear the difference. 15 over and over again. They have like a guitar solo and a little intro and all that stuff, but I just left all that out. I didn't feel like figuring it out because I just didn't like it that much. So I personally, I just play it like this anyway, and I move the capo around to whoever's singing to match their voice, but I use those chords when I do the song. Okay? Thanks for watching. Play more guitar, and please subscribe.